For me, it's super amazing that people are coming from all over the world.
Yeah.
So from Australia, from New Zealand, to look at our products, to learn everything about our bus terminals, about our PCs and motors. But the Beckhoff booth has been a little bit smaller in the past. And 20 wow. years ago, when we introduced EtherCAT, how was that, Hans?
Well, it was fantastic. We had a fantastic party, and tomorrow we will also have a fantastic
party.
Yeah, okay,
party, very good.
I think all the Australians are here for the party.
Yeah, rumor has it.
Sounds reasonable.
20 years ago, I think it was over there on the wall over there.
Okay.
So we presented EtherCAT for the first time to the public.
Yeah.
And it was a sensation. Huh? It was really, everybody was surprised. Our own customers were surprised, our own salespeople, because we did it quite secret before. And also our competition was surprised, which is most important, yeah. most fun. And
Olympic spirit, winning.
The Olympic spirit, exactly. And we worked on it for several years. So already starting in the 90s of the last century. And Beckhoff always has been a company which is looking for high performance and ease of use, both. Yeah. And so we were always looking for communication systems which are the base of an automation architecture. And we were looking for communication systems which would help us to fulfill this demand. And Beckhoff is also standing for IT technology and automation technology combined. And so after a while, it became quite obvious for us that we should use Ethernet. It became affordable and available on all controls. Should be the next generation of I/O. And then, but Ethernet itself is not usable for machines. It's too ineffective mm-hmm. because of its message structure. And because small pieces of information have to be collected in the field. And so we had to find a solution for this, and the solution was EtherCAT, Ethernet for Control Automation Technology. And Johannes, this is what you were very young then, about 20 years ago, you were 6 years old.
Yeah, seven actually.
7 years old, yeah.
Was a nice time.
So you were not part of the team, but
maybe I was on the fair. I don't know.
Just for the sweets. But maybe so. EtherCAT, it has been a success story. So for 20 years, it was going on. Many people adopted in Australia, in New Zealand. Mm. But maybe looking at the technical reasons for this, what is technically special about EtherCAT that people say, yeah, that's the right way to go. That's how we communicate between all the participants in the machine, Johannes, maybe you can.
Oh, so many things, Felix. But let's start with the maybe core characteristic of EtherCAT,
yeah.
Which is, I think, the on-the-fly, that the data is collected and distributed on the fly and is even proceeded and processed on the fly. So you have to see that an EtherCAT frame now comes out of this PC and then goes through all of those I/O terminals.
Yes.
And contains all the data of the I/O terminals, and all those terminals process the EtherCAT frame on the fly, so it does not have to stop in a single terminal. It can just go through, so we don't have any delays like normal Ethernet protocols have. We don't have significant hardware delays, which makes it really efficient and really fast. And of course, as Dad said, we are using normal Ethernet technology,
yeah.
So we are also using as default 100 Mbit as a communication speed, and so and we can even use 1 gigabit as communication speed, as we both use in the Explanar. And I think we both are really happy about this, because without EtherCAT, without EtherCAT G, without this really high performance, we could not use the Explanar, which we are both involved in.
Yeah, it's a very good story that we did this and that EtherCAT works this way. But let me just, like, maybe just one point. Mm. So the Ethernet port came to the PC 20 years ago, and it's still there. So a very well thought through decision, I would say, right?
Yeah, it's always, if you're looking for the combination of commercially available technology and industrial technology, then you have to have a little bit luck, or you have to be good in your decision, so that you're exactly picking the technologies which will survive, because there are also a lot of IT technologies which are not surviving, and then you put your future on the wrong horse, to say it in this way. But we had the luck and that we mostly choose always the right standards. And for sure, Ethernet today, it's completely obvious that Ethernet is the way to go. But in the old times, around 2000, there also have been FireWire
I've never heard that term.
Heard about it and so on, yeah. Yeah. So Ethernet was really the way to go. And it's we optimized it for big machines, so we can control, if you like, 100 motors on with one Ethernet port and with one PC, which is still fantastic. But it's also very usable for small controls. Our smallest controllers, which are really this small and only may have a list price of 200.
Yeah, that's a C-X7.
It's a little bit bigger, this one. Yeah, the very small one is not there.
This one?
This one, yeah.
C-X7,000? Yeah.
The very smallest controller, it's also running EtherCAT as an expansion bus. And so it's... most people consider EtherCAT to be very useful for big machinery, but it's also useful for small controls. So, all this has proven to be correct and right, and therefore has been accepted by a lot of engineers all around the world. If an engineer understands the technological principle behind EtherCAT, normally he falls in love, if he is a good engineer. If he not falls in love, he's not a good engineer.
But that's what we always say. So EtherCAT is so has such a high performance, but if you look at it, it's very easy. It's very lean. And if you look at it, you have to be amazed. So we always say it's the engineer's choice.
Yeah. When you first read really deeply into it, I remember that you told me, how else would you do it? It comes so natural. Yeah. But maybe one thing else, you just had it in your hand and you put it back. So that's a cable. We see a lot of I/O devices here on the table, everything with EtherCAT. But what does the cable have to do with EtherCAT?
Yeah, of course, EtherCAT is advancing, and there are new developments in many ways. And one of those new developments in the past, and which we will also continue, is the one cable technology. Yeah. So of course, the installation on the machine has to be as easy as possible. And every device in a machine needs two things. Power and communication.
It's true.
So usually it needs two cables, but of course it is reasonable to put power and communication in one cable, and so we developed the EtherCAT P, EtherCAT P, which you can see here. So on one cable there's transmitted the power, 24 volts or even higher powers, and EtherCAT, which is also a really big success story, and which will be an IEC norm very soon. So those cables and those
And if it's coming to bigger powers, so the M8 connector is not enough anymore. So we developed a whole series of B, we call this the B-type connectors, and they're going up to 63 amps, three phases, with included EtherCAT communication. And so this is perfect for connecting big motors, big other devices, big parts of the machine. Together, and it's once again it's one cable technology, because Beckhoff, we are proud to be we try to be a high tech company on one side, but we are also a very practical company. We started as cabinet building company in 1980, and my first 10 years I earned the money with cabinet building almost, and so we know how to build a cabinet and how to build how to install on a machine. The electrical installation, and therefore it's quite natural for us that we are going for the one cable technology, something which will become an additional standard to the EtherCAT standard.
I think that's pretty cool that you said this, because you said in the beginning that we decided to develop EtherCAT because Ethernet was becoming the standard, and we picked the standard, and the standard became really important, and it never vanished. Yeah. And now we are setting an own standard with the cable. So I think that's amazing message. Yeah. And maybe just one last thing. So 20 years ago, we introduced EtherCAT, but I don't think there are any different protocol versions. So I think the compatibility is something which is very at the core of EtherCAT, right?
The engineering group who defined EtherCAT in 2003, so about six people inside Beckhoff, they can be very proud because they thought detailed enough, and they could look obviously far into the future, because everything which is needed for such a protocol, only even now, 20 years later, was already built in.
Yeah.
So the original idea about EtherCAT was so well done that no additional changes had to be done over the years to keep up the performance and to fulfill all the needs for our customers. So it's really... The original definition was okay enough, and it's stable, and it looks like that this is going on.
Yeah. So I think that's a wonderful Finnish word. So high performance, standards, and continuity.